Hello my fellow gearheads, today I'm gonna show you how to simply motorize the Blue Dragon that I built as the alternate model of the LEGO Technic 42123, the McLaren Senna GTR. So if you have purchased the instructions, this is gonna be a freebie for you. What are we gonna need for the motorization? We're gonna need one of these Technic forks that allow you to lock a drivetrain in 90 degrees. We're gonna need the 20-tooth bevel gear, the thin one. We're gonna need 12-tooth bevel gear, a 3-module cross axle, 2 axle pins in blue color, and one of these 1.5-module snaps that you can find as well in the leftover pieces from the McLaren Senna if you've built the Dragon, or you can just use any of from your inventory. And then we need as well something to motorize it. So we're gonna use a medium motor, and it doesn't matter if it's gonna be the power functions or the powered up motor, because they have the same dimensions and they're gonna fit perfectly fine in there. But of course, you need a respective power supply for that. So for this, I do recommend the train hub because it's much smaller and more compact. Or with the power functions, I'm gonna be using probably the rechargeable battery, but you can as well go with the regular power functions battery box. And that's all what we're gonna need. And now I'm gonna show you how to do it. So first of all, let's build the main drivetrain. So you take these two blue connectors and place them inside the Technic fork and put it inside the medium motor like so. Then you can take a 3-module cross axle and place it inside the driving shaft of the motor and put a 12-tooth bevel gear. Then we put one of the 1.5 stud snaps over here, and we can simply borrow another one of these ones from the belly of the Dragon, or we can just take it from your own inventory, and afterwards you can replace this one with a black snap, which we have plenty of in the leftover bags. Now we need to get access to the inside of the body, which we can do just by detaching these panels from these connectors to the side and rotating them to the back. Now we need to remove this 7-module beam, and we need to push this cross axle out so we can loosen the structure in here. So we take out this small panel section, and we can take as well these dark gray cross blocks. And then what we need to do is that we take these L-beams out and just rotate the position of these dark gray connectors and place them in the same hole inside the body, so they do not obstruct the space for the motor. And we do the same on the opposite side. Yep, that's it. Now we need to get rid of this cross axle and mount the engine on it, which I'm gonna show you right now. You can simply just disconnect the wing assembly, or you can slide the cross axle out and then disconnect the wing assembly, but this will fall out. And now you have access to the cross axle, and what you need to do is that you slide the wheel and the bushes that stop it over here from the inside. So just by pushing on the cross axle, you can slide it out. Afterwards, you take out the wheel and continue pulling. And then I'm just gonna turn it this way. Everything falls inside. And you can take out the wheel and the bushes. And the Dragon is ready for the insertion of the motor. Now you can take these ones, two of these, and just count the holes. So from this vertical beam, it should be in the third hole. basically, and it will be just against the second pin on the fork from the wings, if you can see it over here clearly. And I'm not gonna rip the whole dragon apart just to show you how to insert the motor in a legal way. I'm just gonna wedge it in like so. So just loosen the structure a little bit and then press together, and that's it. The motor is right now in place. So again, you place these ones into the third hole from the vertical beam, so it just sits in front of this row where you have the gray ones, and then you can just place the motor inside. If you want to, you can already put the cable throughout the body to the bottom, and you can start placing the cross-axle in, which should be much easier because we don't have any friction. And then you decide which side of the body you want to put the gear wheel on. I'm just gonna place it over here, hoping that it will be a bit more visible. So it's gonna go like so, and then you just push the cross axle symmetrically around. And then it should be just a matter of putting everything back in place. So you take the Technic forks and place them on the sides of the 9-module cross axle. You can do the same from here. Now you can add the gear wheels to both sides. And right now the tough part comes, which means that you need to synchronize the gear wheels on both sides so the wings are sitting at the same level. It's easier to do it if you have already anything longer attached to the cross axles, like a beam or stuff like that, but it's doable as well. You can rotate it slightly like so, and then you need to have it perfectly horizontal over here as well. So try to line up the gear wheel and then just push the 4-module cross axle with a stop through, and then you need to attach these beams that rotate afterwards with the wings, and fingers crossed they will be properly lined up. So this is how it should look. Both the beams are heading vertically up and the wings have the same angle against the body. And right now you can just close the rest of the body like so, as we had it before. You will lose the one of the crests over here in the back, but I hope you can live with that. And then we need to close as well the belly of the dragon, and as I said, you're gonna just steal one of these black pins from the leftover bag of the parts that you have from the McLaren Senna GTR. And that's pretty much it, and now we are ready to test the dragon and how it's flapping the wings. These are the parts that were taken out of the dragon's body, and we're not gonna put them back in, so feel free to place them with the other leftovers from the set. For operating the dragon, I'm using the rechargeable battery box because you can adjust the speed and change the direction of the rotation, but feel free as well to use the powered up media motor and the powered up train hub or the Technic powered up hub, where you can as well adjust the speeds. And this is the result, which I think works totally fine and looks fairly realistic. So I hope you enjoyed watching the video. I hope that those of you who have purchased the instructions for the Blue Dragon are gonna find it useful. If yes, hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment, and if you are new over here, please do me a favor and subscribe so you do not miss out on any of my future videos. Until next time, everybody, stay safe, take care, and bye-bye.